themselves by the name of Jesus Christ, who would have the testimony of saying, I am, by virtue of the atoning blood of Jesus Christ on Calvary, saved. Everyone who defines their Christianity that way, this message is for them. My God, let there be a spirit of repentance come on your church. Beloved, several years ago, listen to me like you've never listened to me, ever in your life. Several years ago, a particular gospel landed on the southern shores of the United States. You might say that the American church was invaded. Gospel of laughter, of jokes, gospel of foolishness. I remember seeing this just a few weeks perhaps after this all began. I looked at it and I said to my wife, well, at least it takes absolutely no discernment to see that what this lunacy is. And then, much to my shock, it swept almost the whole Western world, great corners of the charismatic Pentecostal movement. I remember crying out to God, God, how could it be? How could it be? How could this thing happen to your church? You see, folks, we've forgotten something. Here we are in New York, and the Twin Towers have come down, and the Pentagon has been attacked. And rightfully, we can say the walls are down. And the justice of God is touching a nation that has rejected truth. But we forget the judgment begins in the house of God. The arrival of this gospel was the judgment of God on a slumbering church. A church that wanted prosperity and security. They wanted no cross, no work, no repentance, no cutting of the sword, no living water. They wanted to feel good. And so God, you see the Old Testament, poured a spirit of drunkenness on what called itself the church of Jesus Christ. It was the judgment of God. It began in the church, and I remember saying to other people, it will not be long, and the judgment will be touching the shores of North America, because it's begun in the house of God. I knew it when this started. The judgment was at the door. I speak from a heart of passion. I condemn no one. I speak from a heart of passion, like Elijah did. Say, mighty God, you've got to come again. And your people are captured. Your people have been taken captive by Baal. Verse 39 says, when all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and they said, the Lord, he is the God. The Lord, He is the God. In verse 40, Elijah said to them, take the prophets of Baal and let not one of them escape. And they took them, and Elijah brought them down to the brook Kishon and slew them there. Now I want to explain to you the significance of that. We're obviously not called to physically harm anybody in our generation. That's, if anybody ever makes that suggestion, that is not the church of Jesus Christ. That's not the gospel of Jesus Christ. It has nothing to do with the kingdom of God. But the word escape in the Hebrew means smooth. That's what it means. In other words, he's saying, let them not slip here. They've been exposed. You now know what they are. You've seen the presence of God. Don't let them slip away. Don't let them keep deceiving you with their smoothness anymore. Get away from their altars. Take them to the brook, as it is, and put an end to their influence over your life. Beloved Church of Jesus Christ, I know tonight I'm speaking not just at Times Square Church, but there'll be churches all over North America, in particular the United States and Canada, that are going to hear this message. Beloved Church, get away from their altars. Run for your life. The Apostle Paul me read it to you. Don't turn. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. He says, what agreement, verse 16, is the temple of God with idols? You are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Verse 17, he says, wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Touch not the unclean thing. It's not talking about sexuality and pornography. These are unclean altars. This is the table of devils. And the Holy Ghost says to Paul, touch not the unclean thing. Come out from among them. Run for your life. Because this is about your life. It's not just about an opposing theology or conflicting viewpoint on Jesus. This is about your life. My mind is forever branded with the story that I heard of police officers from the city of New York as people were fleeing from a crumbling building. They were fleeing for your life. Sexuality and pornography. These are unclean altars. This is the table of devils. And the Holy Ghost says to Paul, touch not the unclean thing. Among them. It's not talking about sexuality and pornography. These are unclean altars. This is the table of devils. And the Holy Ghost says to Paul, touch not the unclean thing. There's sexuality and pornography. These are unclean altars. This is the table of devils. And the Holy Ghost says to Paul, touch not the unclean thing. It's not just about an opposing theology or conflicting viewpoint on Jesus. This is about your life. My mind is forever. It's not just about an opposing theology or conflicting viewpoint on Jesus. This is about your life. I'll touch not the unclean thing. I'll touch not the unclean thing. Run for your life. Because this is about your life. Saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Touch not the unclean thing. It's not talking about sexuality and pornography. These are unclean altars. This is the table of devils. And the Holy Ghost says to Paul, touch not the unclean thing.